We're back in the office of Clerk of Court Gary Stanga. A big sensation's been created by the new program here, whereby a property owner can register his or her property and hopefully have protection against identity theft and other frauds that happen in this internet age. And it's not just for the internet. I mean, this gives protection, Gary, against even somebody walking in and claiming to be you.
Yes, Ken, but you know, the biggest thing is I think that people have seen as people who are smart enough to prepare the proper documentation in order to do like quitclaim deeds, whereby they would show Ken Benitez is signing his property over to Gary Stanga. I have all the proper paperwork done. I bring it in, have it recorded, and you know, your property is going to be put in my name. That's just one instance. Also, once that's done, once I get it in my name, I could take and go to a lending institution and say, look, you know, I've got this property put in my name. You know, I'd like to borrow $50,000 for some construction or whatever. So all of a sudden now you have a mortgage against your property that you had nothing to do with.
What do you do when that happens?
Well, what you have to do is if once you find out about it, you're going to have to get an attorney. You're going to have to go to court, and you're going to have to prove that it was fraudulent. Also, I would think that the district attorney may be interested in prosecuting people that would do that. We're only in the what we're trying to provide is people a free service to be notified in the event that somebody does file something against their property.
Okay, so how does it work? And Alicia's here, and you're actually going to demonstrate it on the computer.
Yeah, I've got Alicia Fussell, my chief deputy, sitting here, and she's a more proficient typer than I am. That's why I've asked her to do this. You see, when you pull up www.tangiclerk.org, that's our home page. The Protect Your Property button with the red writing on below it right there is what you want to click on. We're going to show you how simple this is. She just clicked on the button, and you click Sign Up Now, and then it's something for you to read, and then you click Continue, and there's a little disclaimer there where you check I agree, and then click Continue, and then you're going to put your first name, your last name, email address, your cell phone number, and a password, which will be unique, and then you confirm your password, and then you hit Create. And now you have an account created. Then, if you click on log on to recording alerts, you put your email, put your password. There you go. Click log in. Now, you're at a recording activity alert account, and it's going to have your name, and you can list different variations of your name, which is a really good thing to do. Like when I created mine, I put Gary Stanga, I put Gary T. Stanga, I put Gary Timothy Stanga, and also my wife in different variations of her name, because on a lot of documents, both the husband and wife sign those documents, so you want it to you to notify. So you see there, she has Alicia Fussell, Alicia, John Fussell, and you can just keep adding. There's no limit to the number of names that you can put on here. And a thing that I want to emphasize first and foremost, not only does it protect you, but it's free. It doesn't cost you a dime. So it's we beg people to take advantage of it. If any of the your viewers that have people, you know, parents, elderly or whatever, anybody, I would say 65 and older, it's good to have them signed up because they're not as likely to be keeping up with their property and stuff.
Well, as we've learned, too, I mean, there are some scams that deliberately target senior citizens.
Oh, yes, definitely. Probably more so than anybody else. You know, I know myself. I get stuff on a daily basis. And, I just delete it. I don't even look at it. Because
the royal family of Nigeria apparently has it in for me.
Yeah, well, I got a message from someone yesterday who appeared to be a good friend of mine, asked how I was doing. I said, I'm doing fine. And then all of a sudden, have you heard about some kind of program where they send you $250,000 and you don't have to pay it back? And as much as I wanted $250,000, I said goodbye, hacker, and I deleted them. So, it's just it's amazing the people, poor people that will fall for some of these scams, because in today's world with artificial intelligence, it's so easy. I mean, you can actually get a phone call, and it sounds exactly like one of your loved ones who they have recorded. And then they use their voice like they're calling you asking for help. They need you to send money or whatever. I mean, there's scam after scam after scam out there, and it's a billion-dollar industry.
Well, we can strike one blow for liberty here by just registering your property.
That's correct, Ken. We're just hoping to help if we can, help save one person's property or one person from being taken advantage of, that will be worth all of our effort.
Well, in the meantime, earlier today, we were over at the new registrar's office, which will clear them out of the courthouse here. And I wonder if you thought about maybe utilizing some of that now vacant space.
I wanted it really bad, Ken, but unfortunately, the district attorney got that space. I say unfortunately, it's good for Scott. I'm sure they need the space too. You know, this courthouse was built, I think, in 1965, and it's, we're probably double the population that we were back then. It's just we're busting at the seams. We could use more space, most definitely, but, I'm not going to complain.
As you showed us on the internet a minute ago, a lot of the activities that used to require a person to physically come to the clerk's office, they can do online now. So that must help.
Well, since I've been at the clerk's office, we have put more and more and more things online for our customers to be able to access. They can access mortgage and conveyance records. If this is assuming that they... We do have to sell subscriptions for those services for the simple reason that I have to have an IT guy that does all this stuff. I have to have, we pay for accounts, for the upkeep of it. And we pay in vendors, in other words, to be able to do this. We have our civil records online. We have... even criminal records online. So, it's when I first came here, pretty much every day there was attorneys, lined up at the counter. There were maybe five or six abstractors back there working, doing abstracts on property. Now we don't see anybody hardly unless they come to court. Everybody can do their work from the confines of their office. People that live in, whether they live in Kentwood or Hammond or Ponchatoula or wherever they live, they can do it without having to drive to the courthouse.
Well, what if there's an old-timer or a person who, for whatever reason, doesn't have access to internet? How do they register their property? I mean, they might show up here and say, I don't know what to do.
We have had some people like that. In fact, I'm not going to call his name. I had a gentleman in my office earlier today. I got Lance Anderson, my IT guy, to come in here. We got the information from him, and we signed him up. We would be happy to do that. You know, preferably, you know, we want people as much as possible to do it. If they have an iPhone or if they, you know, anything where they have can access tangyclerk.org, you know, we would prefer that. But anyone that needs help, you know, if they're elderly or whatever, if they need help, just call us.